thought that the first Godzilla movie had tremendous potential that was unfortunately never realized. Because, of course, Gareth Edwards, as we would learn from Rogue One, where he had to be outrightly replaced as director, he wasn't the best man for the job. And now Warner Brothers, or Warner Media, if you check these trailers, they have already branded them Warner Media, which I think is very interesting after the AT&T acquisition. But they hired an equally inexperienced director for the sequel, Michael Dougherty, who's actually Bryan Singer's protege. I just hope that this movie realizes that the real stars are the monsters, not Millie Bobby Brown, although her legion of fans would disagree with me. Although some people think she's a monster. Let's see how the movie looks. I love behind-the-scenes drama.
Our world is changing. The mass extinction we feared has already begun, and we are the cause. We are the infection.
Nice logo.
But like all living organisms, the Earth unleashed a fever to fight this infection.
Ooh, what is it?
Its original and rightful rulers, the Titans.
Ice
For thousands of years, these creatures have remained in hiding around the world. And unless all the Titans are found, our planet will perish, and so will we.
This is a crazy music choice.
We are the only guarantee that life will carry on.
Oh, I like this international cast. Oh, look, he's a nightlight. It's so beautiful. A Mothra. Oh, wow. It's like a theme park stage show.
You are out of your goddamn mind.
I am sorry, but this is the only way.
The king.
Oh, he's alive again. Hey, Charles Dance. That was a great end shot. Millie Bobby Brown's like, see ya, Mom. You're the real monster. I'm gonna upgrade to Godzilla as my new buddy. I liked the line when Millie Bobby Brown said, you're a monster, to Vera Farmiga, but yet I just saw Newt Scamander get told that there's never a monster he never met a monster he didn't like. So it's crazy that they have the exact same line back to back, and Fantastic Beasts did it first. So I got to give the point to them, even though, you know, it's a great line, but you know, you can't, not all the Warner Media movies can use it. I don't know if I like that name. But you know, the monsters obviously are the real selling point here. That's what everybody's going to go for. I liked when Mothra did his little ballet emerging from the blue from the blue atomic breath. I love the fighter jets behind Godzilla, and I love the blue color. You might remember that the first Godzilla was all about red. This is all about blue. I think it's a great choice, but let's not forget that the first Godzilla had amazing visuals. So I need a little bit more of a sign that the story is better this time. It makes a little bit more sense. I thought the Vera Farmiga was spewing some real cockamamie Nostradamus type stuff there at the beginning. I'm, you know, like eye roll, serious eye roll, Vera Farmiga. But, you know, maybe she has a more compelling case. Maybe her PowerPoint presentation is better than her oral opening. Okay, write your thoughts down below. Thanks for watching with me. You can check out some more videos right now.